نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد أيها الأحبة في الله أتتني مكالمة بالأمس من رجل يستشيرني في بعض الأمور العائلية ومن ضمن كلامه علمت أن زوجته امرأة لا تفوتها صلاة بل غير أنها تصلي الصلوات الخمس إلا أنها تستيقظ للقيام أيضا يعني امرأة تصلي الصلوات الخمس وامرأة تتهجد وتصلي بين يدي الله جل وعلا في آخر الليل امرأة تتحجب امرأة تحرص على قراءة القرآن وعلى تعليم أولادها قراءة القرآن بل إنها تحضر في بيتها معلما لتعليم أولادها القرآن هذا كله محمود وكله جيد ولكن ضمن هذا الكلام علمت أيضا أنها امرأة تحب هذا الموسم أفهمتم؟ تحب موسم عيد ميلاد المسيح عليه السلام أو عيد الكريسماس بل إنها مشغولة بشراء الهدايا لأولادها ولأصحاب أولادها ولزملائها في العمل وتحب أن تفعل ذلك في عيد الهالوين كذلك يا سبحان الله فبعد ذلك علمت أنه لابد من أذكر نفسي وإياكم بأن الإسلام ليس مجرد طقوس ومظاهر وشعارات وإنما الإسلام عقيدة وشريعة ومنهج حياة. Yesterday I received a phone call from someone and he was consulting me about some family issues. And in that call, I learned that this man's wife doesn't miss a single prayer, a single salah. Not only does she pray each of her five daily prayers, but she also gets up late at night to stand before Allah Jalla wa Ala in prayer, what we know as Qiyamul Layl or Tahajjud. When others are sleeping, she wakes up to pray before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. She's a woman who observes the hijab. She is a woman who is very keen to recite the Quran and to teach her children Quran as well. As a matter of fact, she has a teacher coming to the home just to teach her children the Quran. And all of these are clearly praiseworthy things. This is beyond good. This is how, people should strive to be. But I also learned during that conversation that she is very excited during this season. You know what I mean. She's excited because of Christmas. And so she's busy making plans for the family, purchasing gifts not only for her children, but her children's friends and her children or her co-workers. And she loves Halloween and all of these other celebrations as well. وَإِنِّي قَدْ رَأَيْتُ فِي هَذِهِ الْجَالِيَةِ وَأَنَا حَقِيقَةً أُرِيدُ أَنْ أَبْكِي رَأَيْتُ فِي هَذِهِ الْجَالِيَةِ فِي بَعْضِ بُيُوتِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ شَجَرَةَ الْكِرِسْمِسِ رَأَيْتُهَا بِعَيْنَيَّ هَاتَيْنِ يعني لم ينقل لي أحد هذا الخبر وإنما رأيته أنا. And, you know, I've also seen in this community, in some of the homes of our fellow Muslims, a Christmas tree. So when I hear these types of things, when I see these types of things, I am driven to remind myself and the rest of you that Islam isn't merely a set of rituals. Islam is not only about a certain type of appearance. Islam is not simply slogans, but rather, al-Islam is an aqidah, a faith system, a belief system. Al-Islam is a sharia. It is a set of laws that we have to abide by. Al-Islam is a methodology of life or a lifestyle, a way of living. All of this we need to understand. وَعَلَيْنَا أَن نَتَذَكَّرَ وَأَن نُذَكِّرَ أَنفُسَنَا بِأَنَّ الْإِسْلَامَ دِينُ اللَّهِ جَلَّ وَعَلَى إِنَّ الْإِسْلَامَ دِينٌ اِخْتَارَهُ اللَّهُ وَاصْطَفَاهُ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى لَنَا وَلَيْسَ هُنَاكَ دِينٌ سِوَاهُ يعني ليس هناك دين صحيح مقبول سوى الإسلام قال ربي جل وعلا إن الدين عند الله الإسلام. We need to remember, we need to remind ourselves that al-Islam is the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is the religion that Allah has selected and chosen for us. It is the religion that He prescribed for us subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there is no other religion except al-Islam. In other words, there is no true religion other than al-Islam. Our Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, clearly states this in the Quran when He tells us, "Inna ad-deena 'inda Allahi al-Islam," that indeed the religion, that is the true religion, the only accepted religion in the sight of Allah is al-Islam. Jami'ul adyan. سِوَى الْإِسْلَامِ كُلُّهَا بَاطِلَةٌ Every religion other than al-Islam is a false religion. It is a rejected religion. كُلُّهَا بَاطِلَةٌ لَا تُوصِلُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَلَا إِلَى جَنَّتِهِ وَلَا إِلَى كَرَامَتِهِ لَكِنَّهَا تُوصِلُ إِلَى النَّارِ مَا الدَّلِيلُ عَلَى ذَلِكَ الدَّلِيلُ عَلَى ذَلِكَ قَوْلُ اللَّهِ جَلَّ وَعَلَى وَمَنْ يَبْتَغِي غَيْرَ الْإِسْلَامِ دِينًا فَلَنْ يُقْبَلَ مِنْهُ وَهُوَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ Every religion other than Islam is a false and rejected religion. Understand this and know it well. Any religion other than Islam is false and it is rejected. None of the religions other than Islam lead to Allah nor to paradise, but rather all religions with the exception of al-Islam lead to the hellfire, lead to ultimate loss. The evidence for that is found in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for Allah jalla wa ala says, وَمَنْ يَبْتَغِي غَيْرَ الْإِسْلَامِ دِينًا فَلَنْ يُقْبَلَ مِنْهُ وَهُوَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ This basically means that whoever seeks a religion, whoever desires a religion, any religion other than Islam, then it will never be accepted from them. And they will be, in the hereafter, among the losers. وَهُوَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ الْإِسْلَامُ دِينٌ كَامِلٌ إِرْتَضَاهُ اللَّهُ جَلَّ وَعَلَى لَنَا إِرْتَضَاهُ رَبُّنَا سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى لَنَا يقول الله جل وعلا اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا So Islam is a complete and a perfect religion. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has approved of it for us. He tells us subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran what means, this day I have perfected for you your religion and completed my favor upon you. And I have approved for you al-Islam as your deen, as your religion, as your way of life. مرة أخرى هذه أمور لا بد من علمها وكما قلت الإسلام ليس مجرد طقوس ومظاهر وشعارات فهذه المرأة التي أخبرتكم عنها هل فهمت هذا الأمر؟ These are basic principles that all of us must be aware of. It is absolutely essential. Yeah, it sounds like something that everybody would know. But knowing and understanding are two different things. The woman that I told you about just a while ago, does she understand any of this? Did she understand any of this? فَوَاضِحٌ جِدًّا أنه من لم يؤمن بدين الله جل وعلا فهو سيكون من أهل النار وليس من أهل الجنة مرة أخرى ماذا يقول الله جل وعلا عن هؤلاء وهو في الآخرة من الخاسرين It's clear that anyone who doesn't believe in al-Islam, who doesn't follow al-Islam, who doesn't live by al-Islam, then such a person in the hereafter will be from the dwellers of the hellfire. They will not be from the dwellers of الجنة. طيب أقول أيضا إنه لا يوجد مسلم إلا وهو يقول إني أحب الله. There isn't a single Muslim that you're going to find on the face of the earth except that they say that they love Allah. فإن كان هناك من يقول إني لا أحب الله فهو غير مسلم. الأمر سهل. If anyone says that I don't love Allah, then obviously they're not even Muslim. Game over. ولكن نسأل ما حقيقة هذه المحبة؟ ما الدليل على هذه المحبة؟ So the question arises, what's the reality of this love that you have for Allah جل وعلا? What's the proof that you really love Allah? الاختبار في القرآن. The test is in the Quran. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى لنبيه صلى الله عليه وسلم قل إن كنتم تحبون الله فاتبعوني يحببكم الله ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم والله غفور رحيم. It's in the Quran. How is it that our faith, how is it that our love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is tested? Allah Jalla wa Ala addresses His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we see in the Quran, Allah Jalla wa Ala says, say, of course the meaning of the ayah, say that He's addressing the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam. Say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to the people, if you truly love Allah, in kuntum tuhibboon Allah, this is your claim, you say that you love Allah, then prove it. How? فَاتَّبِعُونِي. Follow me. Obey me. Follow my teachings. فَاتَّبِعُونِي. يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهِ. As a result of that, Allah will love you. وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. And He will forgive you your sins. And Allah is most forgiving and merciful. طيب. Even دَلِيلُ محبتنا لله جل وعلا هو اتباع رسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم. So it's clear that the evidence that we love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is in our obeying and following His Messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. بل يقول ربنا سبحانه وتعالى مَنْ يُطِعِ الرَّسُولَ فَقَدْ أَطَاعَ اللَّهِ. هَلْ هُنَاكَ شَيْءٌ أَوْضَحْ مِنْ ذَلِكَ؟ مَنْ يُطِعِ الرَّسُولَ فَقَدْ أَطَاعَ اللَّهِ. مَنْ قَالَ هَذَا الْكَلَامِ هُوَ رَبُّنَا جَلَّ وَعَلَى. And it couldn't be more clear, because we find then in the Quran that Allah tells us what means whoever obeys the messenger, that is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then they have obeyed Allah. Clear? طيب هذا الكلام كله ليش؟ وليش في هذا الوقت؟ Why all this talk now and why at this time? هو بسبب هذا الموسم. It's because of the season. The Christmas season. فهناك من الناس من يرى أنه من التأدب مع الآخر أن نهنئه بعيده وحتى أن نشاركه في عيده. وأنا أقول طيب ألم تسمع هذا الكلام كله الذي قلته الآن؟ ثم أقول إن كنت فعلا تحب الله إن كنت تحب الله جل وعلا الدليل على ذلك اتباعك لنبيه صلى الله عليه وسلم في عهد النبي صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه. ألم يكن هناك كفار؟ ألم يكونوا يحتفلوا بأعياد؟ والجواب بلى. إذن لِنَنْظُرْ إِلَىٰ هَدِي رَسُولِنَا صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ كَيْ نَعْلَمْ هَلْ يَجُوزُ لَنَا أَنْ نُهَنِّئَ الْكُفَّارَ بِأَعْيَادِهِمْ وَأَنْ نُشَارِكَهُمْ فِي احْتِفَالَاتِهِمْ هَلْ يَجُوزُ ذَلِكَ نَنْظُرْ مَاذَا فَعَلَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ. So, as I said, the reason for bringing all of these matters up now again, reminding ourselves of the superiority of al-Islam, and reminding ourselves that there's no other religion that is accepted by Allah other than Islam, and that our love for Allah is proven through our obedience to His Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, all of this is because of the season. Yeah, it's Christmas season. And so many people ask, why should I not congratulate the people on this occasion? Why can I not take part in their celebrations in some way, shape, or form? I mean, isn't it part of good manners? And I say, subhanAllah, we've forgotten everything that we just said. Then I remind myself and you again, the proof is in the pudding. Our proof that we love Allah Jalla wa'ala is in our obedience to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So the natural question then is, during the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, were there not any kuffar? Kuffar is the plural of kafir. Kafir is any person who is not a Muslim. Don't be shy of the word. Allahu Jalla wa'ala used it. The question again, in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, were there not any kuffar? The answer is obviously there were. And did they not celebrate some holidays, some of their religious holidays? And the answer again is yes, obviously they did. So now what we need to do is look at the guidance of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and his attitude toward those celebrations. Did he take part in them? Did he congratulate these people on their occasions? أولاً هناك حديث لعل الجميع يعرفه الآن لأني ذكرته مرارا وتكرارا وهو أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لما قدم المدينة وجد أن للمشركين أو أن للكفار يومين يلعبون فيهما فسأل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ما هذان اليومان قالوا كنا نلعب فيهما في الجاهلية يعني قبل أن تبعث يا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم اسمعوا لجواب رسولنا الكريم صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه قال عليه الصلاة والسلام إن الله قد أبدلكم بهما خيرا منهما يوم الأضحى ويوم الفطر. واضح جدا. وجدهم يلعبون في يومين يحتفلون في يومين هكذا كانوا يعملون في الجاهلية. فالآن قال لا نحن لا نحتفل بهذين اليومين وإنما أبدلهما ربنا جل وعلا بخير منهما وهما يوم الأضحى ويوم الفطر. إذن الدليل هذا واضح جدا جدا على أنه لم يشاركهم ولم يقرهم على هذين العيدين. When we look to the guidance of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, matters become abundantly clear. We learn from the hadith of Anas radiallahu anhu arda that when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam came to Al-Madinah, he found that the people used to play, they used to celebrate on two days. So this was their celebration. When the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam asked about those 2 days, they told him that these are 2 days we used to celebrate in the days of ignorance. In other words, before you were sent as a prophet. In response to that, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam told them that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has replaced these 2 days for them with 2 better days. They are the days of Al-Adha, that is Eid al-Adha, and Eid al-Fitr. So from this it's clear that he did not approve of that holiday. He did not participate in that holiday. He did not approve of it for anyone, not for himself, nor for anyone else. وهناك حديث آخر ذكرناه في السابق وهو أن رجلا أتى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وأخبره بأنه نذر أن ينحر إبلا ببوانة وبوانة مكان قريب من مكة فالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم سأل هل كانوا يعني الكفار هل كانوا ينحرون في هذا المكان أو هل كان لهم عيد يحتفلون به في هذا المكان فحينما أخبر عليه الصلاة والسلام أنهم لم يعملوا شيئا من ذلك يعني هذا المكان ليست له خصوصية يعني لم يختر هذا الرجل نحر الإبل في هذا المكان لأنه مكان كانوا يذبحون به في السابق أو كانوا يحتفلون فيه في السابق فحينما علم ذلك أقره وأخبره أن له الوفاء بنذره أرأيتم إلى هذه الدرجة سألهم حينما علم أنه لم يختص هذا المكان بشيء من ذلك فأقره وقال له أوفي بنذرك. The other evidence is another hadith that I have mentioned many a time, and it is the hadith of that man who came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam telling him that he had vowed to slaughter a camel in a particular place known as Buwana, just outside of Mecca or near Mecca. Before approving of that, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam asked, did the people, that is, the kuffar, the non-Muslims, did they used to offer sacrifices here? He also asked, did they used to celebrate any of their festivals here? When the response came in the negative that no, they did not slaughter here, they did not celebrate here. In other words, this place is not chosen because it is known for something in particular. There is no belief that there is something special about this place, that they used to celebrate their holidays there, or they used to offer sacrifices there. After hearing that, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam told him that he should fulfill his vow because there was nothing to be worried about in that situation. أفهمتم يا إخواني وأخواتي؟ طيب. ثم أقول لكم ماذا يعني التهنئة؟ ماذا يعني التهنئة؟ What does congratulating someone mean? Why do you congratulate someone? Somebody passes their exams. We congratulate them. In other words, we show them that we are happy for them. Somebody has a child. We congratulate them to show them that we are happy. يعني نظهر لهم الفرح والسرور. نشاركهم في فرحهم وسرورهم أليس كذلك؟ هذا معنى التهنئة. أما إذا قتل شخص شخصا هل سوف نهنئه؟ اللهم إلا بعض الرجال ممكن يشكرون اللي قتل زوجته، الله المستعان. على كل لا نهنئه بل نعاتبه، لأن هذا أمر منكر. كيف أهنئ شخصا على أمر منكر؟ شخص زنى والعياذ بالله المسلم، أنا لا أتكلم عن الكافر، الكافر ممكن يهنئ آخر لأنه زنى، أما المؤمن فلا يمكن، لا يمكن في حال من الأحوال أنه يهنئ شخصا آخر على أنه قد زنى بامرأة لا تحل له، لأنه أمر منكر. وإذا هنأه على ذلك الأمر المنكر هذا يعني أنه فرح ومسرور بما قام به ذلك الشخص، وأنه مقر له، وأنه يرضى ذلك لذلك الشخص. هذا أمر معقول وواضح. This is what congratulations are all about, is that you share in the happiness, that you approve of something for someone. Because if a person murdered another, would you congratulate them? Obviously not. How could you congratulate someone for committing a crime and doing something that is evil and rejected? If someone committed adultery or fornicated, and here remember we're talking about Muslims. Yes, a non-Muslim may congratulate another non-Muslim or another person for fornicating, for committing adultery. He was able to sleep with a woman that is not lawful for him according to Islamic teachings, but it doesn't matter to them. I'm not talking about them, I'm talking about the believers. Is it conceivable that a believer would congratulate another because they fornicated? Because they committed adultery? Of course not. Why? Because it is an evil thing. It is something that we reject. It is a crime against Allah Subhanahu wa ta'ala. So congratulating them on falsehood is not even a thought. We would never think of doing it. طيب لا يمكن لمؤمن أن يهنئ آخر على باطل قام به فكيف بنا نهنئ الكفار بأعيادهم وهي باطلة وهي تغضب رب العالمين. So how is it then that we see no problem with congratulating the kuffar or the non-Muslims on their occasions which we already established are false and rejected by Allah Jalla wa Ala and His Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and which anger Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala? أنرضى لهم الكفر أنقرهم على الكفر. Now are we now okay with their celebrations which are based upon falsehood, which are based upon kufr, disbelief? Do we approve of this for them? That is a good question, isn't it? In reality, Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala tells us in the Quran, إِن تَكْفُرُوا فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ غَنِيٌّ عَنْكُمْ وَلَا يَرْضَى لِعِبَادِهِ الْكُفْرِ. Allah Jalla wa Ala tells us what means, if you disbelieve, then Allah is free from need of you. Allah has no need for you. Then He tells us Subhanahu wa Ta'ala what means, and He does not approve for His slaves' disbelief. Allah doesn't approve of that for the people. So how is it then that we can approve of this falsehood for others? ليس هو من باب التأدب مع الآخر التأدب مع الخلق أهم من التأدب مع الله عيب عليك أين عقلك. It has nothing to do with being polite and kind. You mean you're okay with showing politeness towards the people while being rude towards Allahu Jalla wa Ala, where is your mind? Have you lost it? وَأَخِيرًا دَعُونَا نَتَذَكَّرْ حَقِيقَةَ مَا يَقُومُ بِهِ هَؤُلَاءِ فِي هَذَا الْإِحْتِفَالِ. هؤلاء ماذا يقولون؟ يقولون إننا نحتفل بعيد ابن الله، أليس كذلك؟ بلى، هذا هو أصل هذا الاحتفال. Let me share a hadith with you which will shed light on the reality of what these people are doing. I mean, what, in a nutshell, what are they celebrating? They are celebrating the birth of someone they claim is the son of Allah. This is how it is. This is, I mean, listen to the ads that speak of Christmas. Listen to the preachers of Christianity. This is what we learned from them. طيب أليس عيبا أن نقرهم على ذلك لأنهم بقولهم إن عيسى هو ابن الله هذا القول هو شتم لله جل وعلا. أي والله. والدليل على ذلك يخبرنا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عن ربه عز وجل. يعني هذا حديث قدسي. يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال الله عز وجل كذبني ابن آدم ولم يكن له ذلك وشتمني ولم يكن له ذلك فأما تكذيبه إياي فقوله لن يعيدني كما بدأني وليس أول الخلق بأهون علي من إعادته وأما شتمه إياي فقوله اتخذ الله ولدا اتخذ الله ولدا. هذا شتمهم لله جل وعلا. وأنا الأحد الصمد لم ألد ولم أولد ولم يكن لي كفوا أحد. إذن بأي حق نقر غيرنا ونهنئهم على شتم الله جل وعلا؟ أليس هذا بكفر؟ احذر أيها المسلم، والله إنك لو هنأتهم بعيدهم الباطل هذا فأنت على خطر عظيم، قد تكون قد كفرت بالله جل وعلا. أقل ما فيه أنك ارتكبت ذنبا عظيما يخشى عليك الكفر، يخشى عليك الكفر. In this hadith Qudsi, that is, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is relating directly from Allah Azza wa Jal. I'll give you the quick meaning of the hadith. In it, he says that Allah Azza wa Jalla says that my slave has accused me of lying, and he had no right to do so. And my slave, that is the son of Adam, actually says Ibn Adam, the son of Adam, in other words, people. The son of Adam has insulted me, and he had no right to do so. As for him accusing me of lying or lying against me, then it is his saying that I will not bring him back to life after he dies. And as for him insulting me, then it is his saying that I have a son. While I am the one and the unique I am the eternal refuge. Lam alid wa lam ulad. Neither was I born to anyone, nor have I given birth to anyone, nor do I have offspring. And there is none like unto me. So be cautious. They believe that on Christmas Day, the Son of God was born. So they are directly insulting Allahu Jalla wa Ala. So know this. If you congratulate a non-Muslim, a kafir, on this festival of theirs known as Christmas, then you are approving of them insulting Allahu Jalla wa Ala. And anyone who approves of Allah being insulted in that way, then they have disbelieved. Oh, it's dangerous. Oh, it is a lot more serious than anyone can possibly imagine. The least that we can say is, if we say that you have not disbelieved, the least that can be said is that you have committed such a major sin that it is feared you have left Islam. That is the best that can possibly be said. There is no such thing as, you know, an innocent congratulation. No. Would you congratulate a fornicator? Would you congratulate a murderer? Obviously not. Would you congratulate a pedophile? Obviously not. So how then can you congratulate people for insulting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Aina mahabbatuka li rabbik in kunta tuqirra al-kafira ala shatmi rabbika subhanahu wa ta'ala. Aina mahabbatuk wa aina dinuk wa aina imanuk. Where is your faith? Where is your commitment to your religion? Where is your love for your creator when you approve of people insulting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Innaha kabira, innaha lakabira, innaha al-kufr. It is a major sin, and it is disbelief. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، أيها الأحبة، أعيد وأكرر كلاما لطالما قلته، وهو أننا ولو لم نقر الكفار على كفرهم فليس هذا إذنا لنا أن نسيء إليهم. أفهمتم؟ الأمر واضح. كوني لا أقرهم على أمر لأنه أمر باطل لا يعني أنني الآن أسيء إليه وأظلمه. لا، من قال بذلك؟ قال بذلك الإعلام الكذاب، قال بذلك الجهلاء والمنافقون فيما بيننا. هذا هو من قال بذلك. أما نحن المسلمون المؤمنون فلم نقل بذلك يوما ما. My brothers and sisters, yes, we do not approve of disbelief. We believe that all religions other than Islam are false and they are rejected and they lead to the hellfire. Yes, we do not congratulate non-Muslims, kuffar, we do not congratulate them on their festivals because they are based on falsehood, because it contradicts our aqeedah, our creed, our belief system. But does that mean it is a license for us to be violent against them and for us to treat them in an ill manner? Absolutely not. I have said this repeatedly and I'm saying it again. We reject their falsehood, but we continue being kind toward them. We continue being fair and just with them. Who then says that it's okay for us? It is a license for us that we now reject their false beliefs and we don't approve of their holidays. Who says it's okay for us to be violent toward them or to treat them badly? Who says that? The lying media says that. And the hypocrites amongst us say that. As for us, the believers, the true Muslims, never have we ever said that, nor shall we ever say it. Allahumma a'izz al-Islam wal-Muslimin, wa adhill al-kafarata wal-mushrikeen, wa dammir a'da' al-deen, wa ahlik al-zanadiqa wal-mulhideen. اللهم انصر المجاهدين في سبيلك في كل مكان اللهم ثبت أقدامهم واربط على قلوبهم وأنزل سكينة عليهم وانصرهم على عدوهم وعدوك يا عزيز يا قوي اللهم انصر إخواننا المستضعفين في كل مكان اللهم خذ بأيديهم وعجل بنصرهم اللهم خذ بأيديهم وعجل بنصرهم يا عزيز يا قوي اللهم أرنا في أعدائك عجائب قدرتك اللهم اجعل تدبيرهم تدميرا عليهم يا عزيز يا قوي يا جبار يا منتقم اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطنا وارزقنا اجتنابه اللهم ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين قوموا إلى صلاتكم رحمكم الله